Ah, Scunthorpe. Aside from having a swear word in its name, Scunny's perhaps best known for steelworks. Or what's left of them.
It's not the easiest of places to work, but there's a good laugh. We all got on.
Meet Dean. He used to work on the steelworks. Now he and his family get by on the social. And it's the same for most of the people he knows.
Got no else to do up here but breed and feed, have we?
To survive, they've had to learn how to make their money stretch.
Bit on the side, eh? Chicken fillets, kid.
I'll buy a razor or some links.
The kids have found their own ways to enjoy themselves.
Officers, having a good day!
There's always rough justice when it all gets on top. And if you really need a break, you can have one. At Her Majesty's pleasure.
Shoplifting.
And in Buckingham Palace, but if you scratch the surface, people are just trying to do the best with what they got. And they haven't got much. For Dean, his wife, and their soon-to-be seven kids, and families just like them round the country, this is what it means to be skint. It doesn't matter if you're a millionaire or on the social. Family means the world. And raising your kids is the most important job you'll ever have. And it can be a good deal tougher than any job on the steelworks.
Your responsibility is to ensure that you nurture them, that you give them the love that they need in order for them to live the kind of lives that are meaningful.
For Dean, the only good thing about being out of work is having the time to be there for his kids and the rest of his family.
We've got a strong family. And
we have now.
We always have.
Now
it's
I've joined.
Bigger and bigger.
Now I've joined.
No, Dean's done a lot, you know, he's been there. He's,
Dean's
like a stepdad anyway.
Claire, you know,
all right, let's not get his head too big.
If I could give respect to anyone, you know, apart from my dad, it'd be Dean. You know, he's like a dad to me as well.
So. We're not.
Shut up, you're going too far now.
No, that's it.
But for some, the pressures of unemployment are just too much, and they turn to booze or drugs. And it's their kids that pay the price. Westcliff's local window cleaner, Pete, is a dad, and often pretty cuckooed. But most people wouldn't let anyone else clean their windows.
Hey, that'll do. Are you going to get down now?
Don't like it.
Get him down.
Does everyone know Pete?
Who doesn't know Pete? He's a character, isn't he, bless him? Where do you want this, boy?
No, just leave me here. Can I have a cigarette?
I'll make you a fag. Say hi to Pete.
Hiya.
Say hi.
Hey, I'm window cleaner. Oh, shit. No matter. Sorry.
No,
he's the only person I know who's never claimed off the social and he's paid for his own... His own drink, everything off his own back. He's got his own fucking business.
Yeah, cheers.
He's a good lad.
Yes. All right.
He's one of them men that you just want to, you want to cuddle him because it's just so sweet, isn't it? I think a lot of people take piss out of him, but I don't know why. It's fucking harmless. But he doesn't do anyone harm. He doesn't bother anyone. He doesn't go robbing. Or
I ain't got it in my system to go rob someone.
No, Good. Yeah, you don't want him, don't you? Yes.
That penny sweet. Put it in your mouth and the alarm would fucking go off. Fat bastard took it. Pete's one in a million, mate. One in a million.
So proud of his little boy. Oh,
it's so cute.
As well as paying his own way, Pete also provides for his girlfriend Emma and their son Ty.
All right.
Emma used to work in insurance, but had her own run-in with drugs. She kicked the habit when she got pregnant with Ty, and has been stable on methadone ever since.
What did you get your sticker for?
Sticker for it. Where you going at school?
Tidy.
For being tidy, you?
Yeah, right.
Tidy?
Best boy, aren't you?
I'm tidy, yeah.
Yeah, there's another.
Pete definitely still struggles with his demons, though.
I went to the park with them. Pete was all right with Ty. So I said, right, I'll go get a bath bring Ty back in an hour. And Pete came back in the hour, but he didn't have Ty with him. He was well out his head, proper. Do you know what I mean? He could hardly stand up. And I'm like, where's Ty? He's like, I don't know, over there somewhere. I goes, what do you mean you don't know? He's like, do you know, over there somewhere. I goes, well, who's he with? I don't know. And he really didn't know. So I went upstairs, got dressed. By the time I come down, a police car was pulling up outside. So I start crying automatically. I'm like, oh, my God, where's my son? Pete had left without Ty, do you know what I mean? Just forgot Ty was with him or something. So obviously Pete got arrested for being under the influence and in charge of a minor. And then obviously they had to ring social services. And then obviously because of that, Pete didn't allow Ty on his own. And it was all right, but it could have been worse, couldn't it, baby?
Yeah.
Who loves you? Yeah.
I'm his dad, you know what I mean? Like, what do, like, he's like, dad, I want to go with dad, you know what I mean? How do I explain?
With Emma's history of drugs and Pete being off his head a lot, social services are keeping a close eye on little Ty, making sure he's in safe hands.
Can I have a look?
Look, look at that. Is that you and me?
Yeah.
Hiya. Wave. Daddy and son.
When Pete's not up a ladder or playing with Ty, you can usually find him at the wall. The wall attracts all sorts, some of them with nowhere else to go. Just next to the wall, at the community centre, a local group tries to help people get off the wall. Their volunteers offer a bit of counselling, support, and even throw in a bacon bat for breakfast.
I'll give you one of them. That's the leaflet that sort of explains what we do.
You know, we don't judge anybody, and we take them how we find them, and that's it.
Helping out for the first time today is Gail, who's been unemployed for years and whose life is perhaps as complicated as the people she's helping.
I wanted to do this for the last 2 years since my partner died. He was 37 years old when he died. And to see him come off heroin and get his life sorted out and then to go on drink and then to die through drink, it's hard. It's really hard.
Hardest hit when her stepdad died was Gail's youngest, Skye, who was 13.
This is a poem Skye wrote. I understand how hard it was to stop drugs like you did. Maybe I didn't notice before, but then I was just a kid. Maybe one day, when I die, I will see you again, because then my tears will be happiness and it will stop all this pain. I love you, and there's so much I could say. Sleep tight, Daddy. See you again someday. And that for a 13-and-a-half-year-old to write something like that, to say that children grieve in different ways to adults, Sky just went off the rails.
For Sky, going off the rails has meant getting into lots of fights.
You're always getting involved in other people's arguments, yeah, and that's why you end up fighting, and you're the one what gets into trouble.
Yeah, but it's because I can. Because I can do that, and if I want to do it, I can. Because I don't give a fuck, you know what I mean?
It was nothing to do with you, but you got involved, and you hit that girl.
Yeah.
And then there's another, when you was with your friend, and her dad came and chased you in Aster. What about that? It's not fun. That's not funny.
But do you know what, yeah, that's for sticking up for your fucking mates, that. Of course it is, man. She built it in her stomach and winded it, so I just went over. I was just like, boom! Dropped it, banged it, fucked her up, stamped on her head and everything, man. And then that's when her dad come and chased me.
It might have been 3 years since she lost her stepdad, but Skye still hasn't come to terms with it.
If we mention his name, she has to go out of the room if she gets upset. And if she's had a drink,
fucking. And anybody mentions names or mention his name,
she goes mad.
She goes mad. Absolutely mad.
The Westcliff estate was built for the steelworkers, so it's no surprise that as the works have laid off, Westcliff's taken a bit of a beating. Mind you, there's always windows need cleaning.
Oh, Pete, you've left it right fucking stain there, mate.
Pete, you are.
That's not how you do it, man. You fucking have to turn into it, man. S shapes. There you do, I've done it before.
Yeah.
Right.
Get your hands off the windows!
Is that wrong? That
not being funny, I couldn't imagine not working, do you know what I mean? I've always worked all my life, I have. I couldn't imagine being on the dole. It's not my cup of tea. But I'm not knocking anybody who wants to be on the dole. They can be, do you know what I mean? But I like to keep myself occupied.
Have an elbow grease, Pete.
You hear them all whinging at me, do you know what I mean? But they all like to do what I'm doing, do you know what I mean? Like, you feel better, like, if you're getting money for something, what you do you know what I mean, and just bumming it.
Dean's little brother Greg's been bumming it for months now, but he's not sitting on his arse.
OK, thank you, bye. Well, unfortunately not allowed to take anyone on board that's colourblind.
Well, why did you say out, you think?
Because if I take a job and I end up killing somebody... and it comes
back, what is it?
Firefighter.
How can you... You won't fucking get that wrong anyway. You know what a fucking fire looks like, you know?
Dean.
You defeated the job before
Dean.
You even fucking rung up for it.
Yes, but Dean, she says, do you suffer from any eyesight problems, health, or
get
whatever?
Out,
yeah. And I have to tell her that. If I don't
you
tell
do
her that, I can't lie.
You suffer from health problems. Been a thick bastard.
Okay. I'll ring staff for it.
Fucking hell.
Dean might give him a hard time, but Greg is trying everything he can to get a job.
This is like CRB check my criminal record.
What's the criminal record like?
It's pretty good, actually. I've only been arrested once. Did say, like, you didn't need, like, previous experience, do you?
Yeah.
I need previous experience.
It'd be nice.
Yeah, how many jobs do you think you've applied for?
What, this month?
Yeah, this month.
I'd say about 30, 33.
With so many in the same boat, it's not surprising that people get what they can on the side. Nothing big, just everyday stuff to help you get by.
I always see the people who shoplift how to get my cheap makeup and that. I'm like, yeah, when you're getting some makeup, your man's mine, do you know what I mean?
Because you're on benefits, you can't afford to buy all the proper wash powder and the proper coffee and the proper aftershave and that. So you ask people to obviously rob it for you and you get it for half the price, like, so you can afford it then. So they are providing a service, really, the shoplifters.
Take Tracy. She's one of the best-known shoplifters and no stranger to the police. Tracy's never held down a job for long and grafts to feed her drug habit.
Shoplifting.
Yesterday, she got herself arrested, an occupational hazard.
Six-month supervision order.
What did they get you for?
Just some bedding, just 119 quid worth of stuff. There's our bus.
After a night in the cells, the first thing on Tracy's mind is scoring.
Oh, I feel like fucking shit. It's not a good day.
How long do you normally go without for?
Yesterday I had 7 bags in the morning. Within 4 hours. The gear's shitted. I've had a mouth scrub in the police station. It's come up negative. And positive for cocaine. No, look. Negative for opiates. Positive for cocaine. And I had the opiates after the cocaine. Crack. But I've got no choice but to go and get heroin now, even though it'll sort me out for maybe half an hour.
Tracy's not just known for shoplifting, but for something much, much closer to her heart.
Everyone just looks at me as if to say, she got kids to cover. Even though I'm a better mum than half of them down here. They didn't get took off me from me mistreating them, it was just the way they got took. But people talk about me as if I got them took off me.
Like a lot of addicts, Tracy tried and failed to give up drugs to keep her kids. In the years since they were taken, Tracy's drug use has spun even more out of control.
Smiley face for the camera.
Unlucky for Tracy, she's picked a bad day to be scoring.
Can't get no. No one's... I've just told you. No one's got no... There's three gear dealers down here in this area. But one of them only has it now and again. And the other two just fuck about and wait till they've sold it all to go get more. Whereas you should wait till you get to your last few bags and then go get some more.
How much money are you spending a day?
I'd say probably about 80, 90 quid. But most of the time more.
How do you get that kind of money each day?
Shoplifting and prostitution.
Lads are phoning him up in Grimsby, saying he ain't got none.
Yeah.
So you got it?
Yeah, after half an hour. Breakfast, dinner and tea. Right, now I'm afraid you'll have to turn the camera off.
But why is that? Where do you inject?
In my groin. And if you want me to pull my pants down, you'll have to charge it.
My real parents, they were drug users. They died of AIDS, which was through drugs.
Come on, please.
My dad used to do chemisover, which was a lot easier in them days, a big thing. He went to prison for it. And at the same time, my mum found out she wasn't very well. So we ended up in a foster home. It was only supposed to be for 3 or 4 weeks, but my mum found out she wasn't going to get any better and we was actually there a good 14 years.
How are
you going to bed? Growing up, I thought that they'd given me up because they couldn't be arsed with me. It took a long time for me to sort of forgive them, if you like. Do you know what I mean? I did grow up hating them, you know. You've been rejected, which obviously it's not as simple as that, but as a kid, that's how I saw it. Do you know what I mean? God, my own parents don't want me, so what kind of monster must I be, do you know what I mean? Right, baby, 2 minutes. That's why I'm fighting tooth and nail for time not to go in care. He would not understand where I'd gone, why I'd left him, so he would do nothing but scream for me. He wouldn't eat, he wouldn't sleep, he'd be scared, he'd be angry. He just would not understand where's mummy, why has mummy not come to get me. To get what I mean, he's too young to understand and he'd just think I'd abandoned him. If I can't even succeed as a mother, what kind of a person, you know, what is the point of me? Do you know what I mean? Sweet dreams, baby. How much must mommy love you? A million times more than all the stars in the world.
Hi,
hello.
Come
in. How are you doing?
I'm all right, thank you.
Good. Well, Emma and Paul from Humber Care.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Nice to meet you.
Hi. Sorry, I'm just eating a Jaffa cake. Do you want a drink?
No, I'm
Okay.
Emma's asked for some help in her battle to keep Ty. She's been given a charity support worker to help her with pretty much everything, starting with her debts.
All the utilities, i.e. your water, your electric and gas, everything is set up, mm-hmm. but you're not making payments at this moment in time, is that fair to say?
Or... The gas and electric are token meters, right, so obviously I don't.
Okay.
The water, no, I don't pay that.
Right.
I start paying it, then I miss a couple, and then I can't afford to catch up with it, and instead of doing something about it, I just leave it. And
this is what we can
I'm
help you with.
I'm good at burying my head in the sand.
Yeah, the ostrich manoeuvre.
Yeah.
But these are the things that we can help you with.
Okay.
We can help you plan, we can help you strategize, mm-hmm. look forward, and get you looking in that right direction.
Okay.
See you
Friday.
Thanks
ever so
much. All right, you take care.
See you soon, thank you, bye.
Tracy's got money worries of her own. She's had to borrow to buy her gear today, and now she needs to pay it back.
No,
what are you calling?
Them. But you want to get, I want to get 60 quid for them. If I was to sell them, I'd get a bit more.
Hi.
Hiya.
What can I do for you?
Can I put these in on buyback, please?
Yeah, of course you can.
Fall back in it. Money when I need it.
You've used this before, haven't you?
Yeah, I only got them back last week.
Yeah, that's all right. All right, so you've got £60 all together. 20, 40, 60.
Thank you very much.
All right,
see you later.
Have
thank
nice
you.
Day.
See you later.
Pick 60 quid.
Yeah, it won't last long though. I owe all that out.
So, what do you need to do now?
I need to see if I can get in a shop. But I don't know.
What for?
To pinch something.
I'm on a bit of roulette and taking 5p. Hey, AJ, 36 to 1 I'm paying.
Money's always on your mind when you haven't got a job.
8 and 11.
Right, and where's that?
27. No more of it. Got it! Get in there, son! Fucking! Come to daddy!
If you're up against it and the banks have turned you down, you can always borrow money from the wall. It's not exactly free, though.
If you need cash quick, then just come to the wall and just lend double bubble.
There's loads of people lend money around here for, like, double bubble and that. Do you know, like, you have to pay double back? I don't do it myself, man, I'd rather not, but I know people that do.
Double bubbles, you lend 20 for 40 back, or, like, 40 for 80 back.
What happens if they don't pay it back?
Then it just gets doubled again. And then if you don't pay it back, you just get a kick in.
What sort of people use the money then?
Smackheads, weedheads, alkies, doll dossers, even people who work.
Dee! Where do you want the telly to go?
Up here.
Up here, front room upstairs, yeah.
Dean's been able to steer clear of double bubble. But he still ends up paying through the nose for stuff he needs. Their toddler has broken the telly, so they're upgrading to a bigger one on the Never Never.
It's an LG 3D cinema screen, 47 inch.
Don't forget the smart bit.
Smart, sorry.
That's one head of the TV.
Yeah, it will be.
Anyway, just check it, panel. Oh, as you can see, yeah, panel's all fine, yeah? See you later.
See you later.
See you. Cheers, lads. Well, we're having to pay for it weekly. By the time we finish paying for it, £2,500. £1,800 to £2,500. That's what it said on the slip. I'm sure we could have got one cheaper, like, but I ain't got the money.
What would you say to people that say, look at that? Family on benefits and look at the TV they've got.
That's what you got Bright House from. Pay weekly.
I don't care what they say. We're having to pay for this over 2 years. We can't afford to go out and get one straight away like them working class people who's got, what, £2,000 a week coming in. We're having to suffer paying an extra 1,300 quid on top to pay for it weekly. It's a bollocks to them. Who gives a shit what they think, anyway? It's us who's paying it, not them.
There's nothing beats watching a 3D movie with surround sound from the comfort of your own sofa. Gail's daughter Skye has been fighting again, and this time the troubles followed her home.
People want to know, you know, who live around here, and that's what's happened to your windows, what's happened to your windows. Well, what does it look like? You know, it's not a new fucking trend, is it? All your windows smashed. Oh, what's that? They must be boarding it up. Oh, they're putting them boards on.
We've been told to.
Just the broken ones. Well, they're all fucking broke, aren't they?
Yeah, we've got to do it, haven't we?
Eh? No, I don't fucking think so. You haven't got to live here, have you?
If it rains, yeah, you're going to be knackered, aren't
you? I know,
you?
Yeah.
And I ain't coming back at 5:30. Yeah, I'll tell you now.
Look at it in here, fucking hell. I'm going to have to put all my fucking lights on now. I take the fucking piss, he did. Fucking hell. I shouldn't have to live like this. I know she's my daughter, but I won't dream of going round to someone's house and doing this and coming in your house. I know, you know, they come in and all. They just didn't do then. They started kicking all doors off. Well, they did that. They did that. Right, and they did this. Kicked that off. Kick that off there. This one. I've done to that, look. From the other side. That's what's left of the door.
It's hard to say how kids will react to losing a parent. It's changed Skye, almost beyond recognition.
That's Skye. Everybody liked her, everybody loved Skye. Everybody did. I've got one there of Skye when she was 3. When I look at, you know, I look at her photographs and I see her now, I just think I'm going to get a knock on the door saying, your daughter's been in an accident. We've got her in the police station. You know, she's killed someone or most of them facts, like, she's really done some serious damage to someone. I just don't know now with her. The way she's carrying on at the minute, I don't think she's going to see 18.
Gail's lived in Scunny for 18 years, but the attack on their home has shaken them so much that Gail reckons there's nothing for it but to move.
What are you going to do this afternoon, Pete?
I'll go with... I think my little boy up with them at police at 5 o'clock time.
Pete may be keeping the estate's windows clean, but the same can't be said for himself. He's not laying off the drink or the tablets, and social services don't want him around Emma and Ty.
Well, they say, oh, we don't want Pete like, having any contact with you. Like, Ty, like, with Emma, meaning his mum, fuck knows why. Like, do you know what I mean?
Yeah, why do you think?
I don't know.
But it doesn't help, do you know what I mean? Look at him now, you know?
What do you mean, look at me? I'm not on tablets today, have I, like?
But you don't look great, do you, Pete?
But I'm not on tablets,
have I? I'm not saying what you have or haven't had, Pete. I'm just saying you're not doing yourself any favours.
Oh, no, yeah, I know.
You're not on top form, are you? If my social worker was to walk in now, she'd think that you'd had something. You know she would.
Yeah.
Pete knows he wants supposed to be at my house if he'd had a drink, and he knows he wants to stay at my house. He doesn't care. Well, he still comes, you know what I mean? Drinking beer, coming up to my door, Spider-Man,
singing that stupid song. Might as well put a notice, you know, I am out my head.
Had a good day? I've missed you. If it come down to it, where the only way I could keep tie was to give rid of Pete, then I would. And Pete knows it, it's not a secret. Time means the world to me, I am.
Thank you. I couldn't go to bed and get up in the morning knowing that I've had him and I've lost him. As awful as it sounds, I'd rather not had him before. I couldn't function with my life knowing that I've had this beautiful thing as part of my life and then all of a sudden it's not. It'd kill me. I'd rather not live.
There isn't a day goes by that Tracy doesn't think about what she's lost.
Me and my boyfriend, we both wanted. The police come to arrest him, I wanted, and I didn't have a phone or anything. So the police said I had 20 minutes to get home, to get the kids. I obviously went home till an hour and a half later. They'd made the call, but the transport had not come. So, but they tried reversing it, and they said they can't reverse it, so I had to pick my kids up out of the cots, fast asleep, and go put them in a police car, and then didn't get them back. Was meant to get them back the next day, but because of the drugs and the shoplifting, I think they're better off taking them away. I had my last contact a week and a half ago. It does say clearly that I'm not a bad mum. It's just the lifestyle and shoplifting and drugs. I don't really see the point. There ain't no point in life, is there really now? When you have kids, your kids are your life, aren't they? Take away them and you ain't got nothing left. And that's what I feel like anyway.
Yeah. Emma's decided that she needs to move away from Pete and away from the precinct where all the addicts and dealers know her.
I've got to go for urine tests once a week. First dirty I give, Ty's gone. I've been told Pete's not allowed at this house. If he's seen the air, Ty's gone. I avoid that precinct as much as I can because you go down and people are like, do you want to borrow money? No. Do you want to buy this? No. If you buy it for me, I'll sort you out. No. If I've got some, let me come to your house and I'll sort you out. No. Do you know what I mean? They just don't. It's like uncomprehendable to them that I'm putting my child before drugs, do you know what I mean?
Aye,
come in a minute.
I'm cutting them in pieces for my dinner.
A support worker, Paul, has come to help Emma apply to get herself moved.
Dad, I'm going to the moon!
Looking for the future, it would help my son if I was to move. Yeah, given the opportunity, I like it, yeah.
To move. Therefore, I'll make a fresh start.
Yeah, which would enable me to make a fresh start, yeah.
I think if Emma gets a new place, it'd be good for her.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah,
so you support that one?
Yeah, definitely. Once you get away from me, it's
So, on to the next section.
2 minutes, baby.
Are you angry at yourself?
Yeah.
No, there's nothing else I can do. I've got to concentrate.
Yeah, definitely.
Thank you so much for
Silly, do you know what I mean? How old I am and that.
Kate, this is my own bouquet worker, Paul. Paul.
Hiya, mate. Yeah. Hello. So you worked with him earlier,
yeah.
Didn't I?
Yeah, you did, yeah.
Like, he's trying to get him help to move and that.
Yeah, that's the plan. Just, anywhere within like, North Lincolnshire and anything in the North East Lincolnshire.
Yeah, I get what
like, so it could be a way away, but.
You're in the step in the right direction. You've done a good thing today.
Thank you ever so much.
All right.
Well, you did the most of it, but thank you. I really do appreciate it.
I know
thank
you do, it's all right.
All right, thanks again.
I'll come with you back and go back.
Obviously, the best thing is for him to have his dad about, but when his dad's been how he is at the minute, that's not the best thing at all. They're a good guy, he really is. He's got a heart of gold. But it's just them fucking tablets.
I love you.
Since I've lost my kids, I don't care anymore. What else have I got to lose? Apart from my head.
Once you get reputation, like, it can stick, do you know what I mean? It's hard to get, like, it can be hard to get rid of. Like you say, your best chance is, like, to disappear, like, to go to another estate or another town, like, if the truth be known.
It's taken months to sort out, but Gail's on the move. And she's hoping Skye's reputation won't follow them.
Look at me pots. Putting some big flowers and some hanging baskets in there. 5 months now without any windows. 18 months without any eating. I've been packed a week. So I'm raring to go. This is my shower. Oh, look at that. This is my kitchen. You know, it's like a palace, isn't it? Eh? All new central heating. Life throws some things at you sometimes, doesn't it? And you've just got to get on with it. You've got to be strong. And if you're not strong and you're weak, you fall apart, don't you? This is Skye's bedroom. Oh, yes, I'm all chuffed.
But before she can start her new life, she's got to pack away the old one. With all her kids coming to help, it's brought the whole family together.
Put the bags in first, he said, didn't he?
Nah, the bags have already
been there. Shut the fuck up! You're my fucking heavy. Don't even go down, man.
Put the thing back on.
I'm not putting it back on. You can fucking suck my fucking cock, you fucking lady fat cow.
Oh, that's going to have to be sorted, because I don't know how that goes.
Come on, boss. Good fucking riddance.
A lot of people seem to be stuck, one way or another. Tracy's stuck in a cycle of drugs and crime. She's been caught shoplifting again, and this time she's packing for prison.
I have to take them out of the frames. I just made them because I could have had them back. If I'd sorted me out.
How do you find being in jail?
Find it all right. The only thing I miss is being able to have a joint in bed. If you could smoke weed in there, it'd be a luxury holiday. I mean, it does do your head in being locked up behind your door and not being able to go where you want to go. But I suppose at the same time, I'm not shoplifting or prostituting, am I? I'm getting 3 meals a day, showers, telly. The bed ain't very comfy.
If we had nice comfy beds, it'd be all right as well. If I don't go to jail, I don't think I'll be shoplifting anymore. I'll just have to do my other fucking occupation.
Gail's house move's almost done.
Yeah.
But sometimes you're stuck carrying your trouble around with you.
What are you looking at?
Oh, Polish guy.
Why, Polish, why?
What are you looking at?
Why, you drop finish.
Your mate's looking.
Your job, all right.
Yeah, but your mate's looking at me.
You don't, what? Looking, please.
Look at that mess.
Why?
Look at all that fucking mess there.
Why?
It's disgusting.
Why?
What do you mean, why? People's got to walk past, haven't they, with the kids and that?
I know why. Why problem?
Because it's a fucking disgrace, that's why. Cheeky bastards. Do you want to carry a bag?
Why?
Clean it all.
Yeah, why?
I'll give you, because
it's
awful.
Every day crazy.
Well, fuck off back to your own fucking country and make a mess there then, where you fucking come from.
Bye!
Putting a mess with them.
Bye!
I love you, bye.
Yeah, you fucking perv.
Yeah. Emma's surer than ever about moving. But for now, she's stuck in Westcliff, surrounded by her past.
You can spot it first. I want better for Ty. I want just a normal life, just where I can get up in the morning, get Ty off to school or whatever, go about my housework, do you know what I mean? Do things with Ty at a weekend, save up for holidays, do you know what I mean? I want it to be where eventually I'm off the methadone and everything. Maybe even go back to college, do a counsellor's course. I'll get a little office job or something. Just normal, do you know what I mean?
And there's Dean, stuck living on benefits in the town he was born in. Go back a few years and Scunthorpe was booming.
I think it was the steelworks that made Scunthorpe, wasn't it?
It's
the steelworks that's made it. I think that's all they know Scunthorpe for. It's not the fucking football team, is it?
It produces the best steel in the world.
It's not manned nowhere near to what it used to be years ago when everyone was biking in and there's thousands of blokes coming through this gate. Only thing now is there's thousands of blokes lost their jobs. They've worked all their life and then they get kicked in the teeth. You know what I mean?
Now it seems like there's 10 blokes for every job going.
How many jobs have you applied for, though, in the past 2 years?
I'd say over 250.
4 years, sorry.
Fucking hell. I'd say about 1,000.
No, don't go over the top, you dickhead. How many jobs have you applied for in the past 4 years?
I'd say about 600, 700 jobs.
In the past 4 years?
What kind of wage would a job have to pay you in order for you to keep, you know, your family ticking over now? With
the house that we're in?
Yes. 400 quid a week.
With the house that we're in?
Yeah.
Right
I'd have to be earning about 500-600 quid a week.
What kind of job in Scunthorpe would you get that would pay that?
None. None. I've told her I might have to go work.
That's probably what he probably used to get a couple of years ago off the steelworks, 600 quid a week, wasn't it?
I was on 1,400 quid a week on the steelworks.
1,400?
When I first started. I did every call out, I did every hour going. But I tell you what, I'd have to be earning 500-600 quid a week now, and there's not a job in Scunny that I'd pay that. Not a job in Scunny.
Look at how romantic that smoke looks coming out of the cooling tower. It's like, I don't know.
Shut up, Greg.
But who says you can't get unstuck? Tracy didn't get prison. She was given a drug rehabilitation order and is hoping to turn things around.
I regret the prostitution and not fighting a bit harder for my kids. You can't turn the clock back, can you? If you could, we'd all have perfect lives. Wouldn't we?
No one's life is perfect, and there are no perfect parents. Everyone does the best with the hand they're dealt. But some people have the deck stacked against them from the start. Everyone can hope that tomorrow might be better. They might get that job, make that change, even have that new start.